Every motor show manages to drum up a star exhibit. Motor Fair has bagged itself a sensation. It's this, the Panther 6, a production car with six wheels and a potential maximum speed of 200 miles an hour. When we first heard about it, we couldn't believe it either, so we tracked the Panther down to its lair in Byfleet to learn the full story. Not only is it the sensation of Motor Fair, it's also the show's best-kept secret. It was built at the managing director's home and was only shown to the Panther workforce 6 weeks ago. With the right gearing, this car could do as much as 240 miles an hour. In any case, it's likely to accelerate to 100 miles an hour in 6 or 7 seconds. Its engine is a mighty 8.2-litre Cadillac. Each one of its 8 cylinders, incidentally, has a greater capacity than a complete engine out of the smallest of the new Sunbeams. And as if that weren't enough, the thing is turbocharged as well. In fact, it has 2 turbochargers, giving it a power output of some 600 brake horsepower. That's roughly 100 horsepower more than James Hunt's Grand Prix car. Fuel consumption? Well, if you're lucky, you might get double figures. And just to be on the safe side, there's a fully automatic fire extinguisher. And so it goes on. The air conditioning comes from a transcontinental truck and can fill the open cockpit with refrigerated air, even in Saudi Arabia. It will, by the way, eventually have a hard or soft top option. The 6 wheels, cribbed as a styling gimmick from the Tyrrell racing car, are now supposed to have a practical advantage. Under heavy braking on a wet road, the front wheels lock up, clearing a dry track for the next set of wheels to grip. The front wheels are smaller than the back, so of course you have to carry 2 spares. Inside the hand-finished suede-lined cockpit, the driver is cosseted not only by power steering and automatic transmission, but a 6-way seat adjustment and 2 3-kilowatt heaters, and the last word in electronic instrument displays. There's a telephone, a television, and the glove boxes have combination locks. And the price? Well, if you gave Panther a cheque for £40,000, you would get enough change for a year's road fund licence or 2 fill-ups of petrol, just 50 quid. Bob Jankel is the managing director of Panthers. Bob, 6 wheels, 200 miles an hour, took only weeks to design. Surely it's got to be another one of those one-off motor show gimmicks. It can't be serious.
Very serious indeed. And we don't build motor show gimmicks. Everything that we've ever shown at the motor show, we've built. This car will be in production in the early part of next year.
But where is anyone going to drive it at 200 miles an hour?
Well, they won't, obviously. I mean, the thing is, they just want to be able to say that it will do a faster speed than a Ferrari or a Lamborghini or a Porsche.
Does this represent, you think, a new departure for Panthers, then? Are you coming away from the traditional image?
Yes, well, we've been known, obviously, for building traditional cars until now, and we decided that we wanted to build a traditional car, and if we were going to build a traditional car, we wanted to try and do it better than anybody else in the world.
Finally, in one word, how many orders have you taken for it so far?
We've taken 8 so far.
And the price? Well, if you gave Panther a cheque for £40,000, you would get enough change for a year's road fund licence or 2 fill-ups of petrol, just 50 quid. Bob Jankel is the managing director of Panthers. Bob, 6 wheels, 200 miles an hour, took only weeks to design. Surely it's got to be another one of those one-off motor show gimmicks. It can't be serious.
Very serious indeed, and we don't build motor show gimmicks. Everything that we've ever shown at the motor show, we've built. This car...
Every motor show manages to drum up a star exhibit. Motor Fair has bagged itself a sensation. It's this, the Panther 6, a production car with 6 wheels and a potential maximum speed of 200 miles an hour. When we first heard about it, we couldn't believe it either, so we tracked the Panther down to its lair in Byfleet to learn the full story. Not only is it the sensation of Motor Fair, it's also the show's best-kept secret. It was built at the managing director's home and was only shown to the Panther workforce 6 weeks ago. With the right gearing, this car could do as much as 240 miles an hour. In any case, it's likely to accelerate to 100 miles an hour in 6 or 7 seconds. Its engine is a mighty 8.2-litre Cadillac. Each one of its 8 cylinders, incidentally, has a greater capacity than a complete engine out of the smallest of the new Sunbeams. And as if that weren't enough, the thing is turbocharged as well. In fact, it has 2 turbochargers, giving it a power output of some 600 brake horsepower. Under heavy braking on a wet road, the front wheels lock up, clearing a dry track for the next set of wheels to grip. The front wheels are smaller than the back, so of course you have to carry 2 spares. Inside the hand-finished suede-lined cockpit, the driver is cosseted not only by power steering and automatic transmission, but a 6-way seat adjustment and 2 3-kilowatt heaters, and the last word in electronic instrument displays. There's a telephone, a television, and the glove boxes have combination locks. That's roughly 100 horsepower more than James Hunt's Grand Prix car. Fuel consumption? Well, if you're lucky, you might get double figures. And just to be on the safe side, there's a fully automatic fire extinguisher. And so it goes on. The air conditioning comes from a transcontinental truck and can fill the open cockpit with refrigerated air, even in Saudi Arabia. It will, by the way, eventually have a hard or soft top option. The six wheels, cribbed as a styling gimmick from the Tyrrell racing car, are now supposed to have a practical advantage.